Okay, this is a very simple example on the forward rate agreement. I've explained to you a general concept of forward rate agreement, and I would appreciate if you people could try and attempt this forward rate agreement examples. So try to attempt this example, take 5 minutes, and then we shall start discussing about it. Okay, let's start discussing about it. So we've got a company or a business wishes to borrow $4 million for a period of 5 months in 3 months from now. So whatever the date now is, you are expected to borrow in 3 months now, 3 months from now, for a period of 5 months, which is actually going to be up till the 8th of the month from now. So what happens is you wish to borrow in 3 months for a period of 5 months. So the relevant FRA is going to be 3-8. And since you wish to borrow, so therefore the rate that you are going to be getting is 7.4%, which is the higher rate. Now, what is actually going to happen is we are being told that the company would borrow at LIBOR plus 1%. Requirement is demonstrate how FRA settlements will operate. If actual borrowing is at a LIBOR of 8%, if the actual borrowing is at a LIBOR of 7%. So let me explain to you in the first case and in the second case. What would happen in the first case and what would happen in the second case? So in the first case, what would happen is you would be borrowing at 8%. And in the second case, you would be borrowing at 7%. What happens is the FRA settlement would be like this: 8% less 7.4%. So it's actually going to be 0.6%, which is going to be received by you. So resultingly, you would stand at 7.4% of LIBOR. Because you see, remember, whenever we enter into the FRA is only for the LIBOR. It's only for the variable rate that the FRA hedges. FRA doesn't hedge your fixed portion. This is not hedged by the FRA. FRA only hedges the variable portion. The second thing is, when it comes to this one, there's actually going to be an FRA settlement. And how much is going to be the FRA settlement? So let's try to see this. The FRA settlement is going to be what? It's going to be, the FRA settlement is going to be the 7%, which is the borrowing rate, and the 7.4%. So it's actually going to be 7% less 7.4%. So resultingly 0.4% is what you will have to pay to the bank. So you would end up at 7.4% again. So let me explain to you, in the first case, you borrowed at 8. The FRA bank is going to pay you 0.6%. But when in the second case, you borrowed at 7%, so you would be paying 0.4% to the FRA bank. Now, if I could quantify these numbers, let's try to quantify the numbers. I've just tried to explain to you in percentage terms, but what I'm going to do now is I'm going to try and quantify these numbers in terms of dollars. So if I'm going to quantify these numbers in terms of dollars, let's try to understand this. First of all, what is actually going to happen is that we would say in case number one, the interest paid to the bank is going to be what? It's going to be 8% plus 1% into 4 million into 5 upon 12. Now, why is it going to be like this? Because you have actually borrowed 4 million for a period of 5 months. So the interest that you are going to pay, it will be for a period of 5 months. The interest that you are going to pay, it will be for a period of 5 months. So how much is it actually going to be? It's 9%. Multiplied by 4 million. And it's multiplied by 5 divided by 12. It's multiplied by 5 divided by 12. So there is actually going to be 150,000. That is what it is going to be, which is going to be paid to the bank. And what happens is the FRA settlement. Under the FRA settlement, what are you going to receive? You're going to receive 0.6%. On what amount? On an amount of 4 million. For how long? For a period of five months. So resultingly, what is actually going to happen is 10,000. Resultingly, what is going to happen is 10,000 is the net amount that you would receive from the bank with whom you have entered into FRA. So the net cost is going to be this 140,000. So the net cost is going to be 140,000. Now let's move a bit forward and let's try to discuss the second case. In the second case, the interest paid is going to be what? It will be 7% plus 1%. Why 7%? Because you've actually borrowed at 7%. Multiply by the same 4 million, multiply by the 5 upon 12. So it's actually going to be 133,333. That's what the interest paid is going to be. And if I talk about the FRA settlement, so what is going to be the FRA settlement? Let's try to understand. The FRA settlement is going to be 0.4% multiplied by again 4 million multiplied by 5 upon 12. So it's actually going to be 6667. Resultingly, you would be standing at 140,000. So if you could see in both of the cases, your total cost is going to be 140,000. In both of the cases, your total cost is going to be 140,000. And that's what the major objective of a forward rate agreement is. What is the major objective of a forward rate agreement? The major objective of the forward rate agreement is to actually lock your interest cost. Is to lock your interest cost. You are actually being able to lock your interest cost up to 140,000. If I try to express this 140,000 in terms of percentages, so let me explain to you. You would say 140,000 is the interest that we have paid on a borrowing of 4 million. But this is the interest that we have paid for a period of 5 months. So we should rather annualize this rate. So when you have to annualize the rate, you'd multiply it with 12 divided by 5. So you would resultingly get what? You would resultingly get 140,000 divided by 4 million. And then you would say multiply by 12 and you would say divided by 5. So resultingly, where are you going to stand at? You're going to stand at 8.4%. And if I could explain to you what this 8.4% means, this actually means a LIBOR of 7.54%. What does this mean? This means a LIBOR of 7.4% plus 1%. So that's what the 8.4 is actually all about. So remember, whenever you hedge yourself using the forward rate agreement, this is how things actually go about. You will end up at a fixed cost. You will end up at a specific cost, and that cost is simply whatever the FRA that you have taken plus whatever the credit spread that is applicable. This is termed as credit spread. Whatever the credit spread that is applicable. So that is how you're going to end up paying the interest cost. I hope that this is clear to everyone. Okay, there is a question that we have got. And the question that we have got is that you have made a statement that we will always end up in a loss. So my statement was actually in a loss means that if you have got two rates available, the rate which is going to lead you towards the loss would be the rate applicable to you. That's what I meant to say.